This video shows some practical enhancements of ARCHICAD's built-in CineRender engine, and also demonstrates how to create fast draft renderings. The 3D view is now displaying the living room of a residential design project. We'll use this room to illustrate how to create interior renders using the CineRender engine. Please note that the direction of the sun has already been specified. You can see the sun shadows along the right wall and the floor. We recommend that you begin by selecting one of the fast physical rendering scenes. Let's select the indoor daylight fast physical scene. We'll render the room to get a draft rendering overview. And then we'll modify certain rendering settings to improve the results. This rendering was created in 54 seconds using a run-of-the-mill laptop. It took 20 seconds to calculate the global illumination, and it took 34 seconds to create the rendering itself. It's always recommended that you select the fastest settings when we begin to adjust and fine-tune the rendering settings. Let's display the physical renderer options and decrease the various setting values as shown on the screen. We'll enter 1 for the sampling subdivision, shading max, blurriness max, shadow max, ambient occlusion max, and for the subsurface scattering values. This will decrease the rendering time, which is handy. However, we recommend that you increase these values when creating the final rendering. Let's select the sun option under the environment container. We will decrease the value of the gamma correction by entering 1 for its value. The result will be that the shaded surfaces of the room will appear darker. Let's also increase the sun ratio value by entering 25 for its value. Let's display the global illumination settings. Let's decrease the gamma and enter 1.2 for its value. Let's render the interior space again. The rendering time decreases by 14 seconds, and the image is also more balanced as well. We can use the color correction option located under Effects. Here, we can adjust the saturation, brightness, contrast, etc. of the surfaces. We recommend activating this option only when the final rendering is created. It is also recommended that ambient occlusion is used to ensure a darker representation for the corners. Again, this should also be used only for the final image. Let's have a closer look at the global illumination settings. First, we'll select the primary settings option. The default method is irradiance, cache, legacy. We suggest using this method because it produces fast quality results. Let's enter 200 for the intensity value, as this will provide a lighter image. Let's switch to the settings of the secondary method. The light mapping method is selected here. This is a new engine. Here you can see all the other engines that can also be selected. Each engine has its own characteristics. In most of the cases, it's recommended to use the light mapping engine for the secondary method when creating global illumination. Let's leave these settings as they are for now. We could decrease the maximum depth value, which would result in the dark surfaces being slightly darker. The light mapping engine has even more options. However, most of the time we can use the default values. Let's display the scale option. We could increase the sample size value, but using higher values would result in a lower quality image. It's recommended to use the pre-filter option because this will increase the quality of the rendering, although it will not increase the rendering time significantly. Let's render the interior scene again. The image quality is slightly better, yet the rendering time is the same as before. You may also experiment using other primary and secondary methods. We've used the irradiance cache primary and the light mapping secondary methods because this classic combination produces professional rendering results in a relatively short time. Let's switch on ambient occlusion to enhance the representation of the corners. We will enter 800 for the maximum wavelength because we have a relatively small interior space. We can also slightly decrease the contrast. We should slightly increase the ambient occlusion mask under the physical rendering options. Let's render the project again. By enabling ambient occlusion, the rendering time is increased slightly. However, this creates nice effects along the corners and edges of elements and increases the contrast at the corners. You may continue experimenting with additional rendering options and modify the settings shown.